Good afternoon, church. We would like to welcome you again for this week's online church service. So how are you? How's your family? We pray that everyone is doing well. Church, allow me to start this service by reading Romans 8:18, which says, "For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us." Church, a small background regarding this verse. When Paul was writing this specific verse or this specific chapter, he was in chains. He was locked behind bars. He is contained on a small cell. He is in prison. Isn't that what we feel right now? Being limited of movements, being limited by a lot of rules because of this certain pandemic. Isn't it something that we can relate to him? But church, what I want you to focus on is what he said here. The sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. What we want to highlight here is the faith that he has during that time. We have more movements that we can do compared to what he can, but still, the faith that he showed here is something that we can aspire to have. Amen? So church, let us hope and let us cling to the promise that after this, the glory, the blessings, what we will experience is so good that it is incomparable with what we experience or what we are experiencing right now. Amen? Allow me to read to you Isaiah 43 verses 1 to 3, which says, "But now thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I gave Egypt for your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in your place." Church, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much, O God, for giving us this opportunity where we can just praise and worship your living name, O God. Lord, thank you so much, O God, for using these technologies as a method, O God, Lord, or as a media, O God, where we can spread your word and reach out to more and more people. Lord, we pray that you open each and everyone's hearts for the next couple of minutes and plant a seed on our hearts, O God, on each and everyone's hearts, that will someday blossom to a strong faith to you. Lord, we pray, O God, that you give us hope during these dark times. And we pray, O Lord, that someday, O God, eventually all of this will be over and we will just cling to your promise of the glory that is incomparable to what we are experiencing right now. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, O God, and we're bringing back all the glory and all the honor, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Everything that has breath, praise the Lord. Let's declare the goodness of our living God. Let's shout, "Lord, you are good, and your mercy endures forever." Sing it again. "Lord, you are good, and your mercy endures forever." Come on, church. Sing out. Oh, we sing to you, God. Oh, we give you praise, Lord.
Thank you.
Lord, we come and bow before your throne, Lord God. Oh, we worship you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you the highest praise, Lord. You are good, oh God. You are great, oh God. Oh, how great is your name. How great is your name, oh God. Oh, Jesus, we thank you, Lord God.
Hello, beloved brothers and sisters. Co-citizens of Heaven, kumusta po kayong lahat? Isa pong mapagpalang araw ang akin pong pagbati sa atin pong mga kapatid na kasama po natin ngayong sumusubaybay at nanonood sa atin pong online worship service. Purihin ang Diyos because I believe that God has something in store for each and every one of us. So whatever situations you may be going through today, I believe that the message that the Lord has prepared for you will encourage you and will inspire you to go on with your journey towards His kingdom. At sa oras na ito ay marami tayong mga katanungan sa buhay. Marami tayong mga bagay na iniisip, ano? Dahil napakatagal ng panahon na tayo po ay naka-lockdown, pero wala pa rin nangyayari, ano? Wala pa rin kasagutan sa atin pong mga panalangin. Pero praise God, despite of all the negative things that we are experiencing in this life, praise God, I believe that the Lord has something in store for each and every one of us, which is greater, far more greater than what we are praying for. At through the words of God, yung atin pong mga nagugulumihana ang pag-iisip, yung atin pong mga katanungan ay sasagutin ng Panginoon sa kaparaanan na kung saan ay nakabase sa kanyang mga salita. Kaya purihin ng Panginoon sa oras na ito. I want you to just stay focused on the Word of God, and I believe na habang pinakikinggan natin ang salita ng Diyos, ito po'y magre-rema, magiging buhay sa atin pong mga puso, at habang tayo'y lumalakad ay palalakasin tayo ng Panginoon. Amen? So I would like you to just participate with our service. If you are being touched by the Lord with His Word, praise God, you may type Amen or you may type Praise the Lord sa inyo pong mga chat box upang sa ganun makita namin na meron kayong participation and ma-encourage kami na nandyan kayo kasama namin sa atin pong pananambahan sa Panginoon. Amen? So today, I'm so excited to share with you the message that God has put into my heart. Amen? So, title po ng atin pong pag-uusapan ngayong araw na ito is Come Boldly to the Throne of Our Gracious God. Amen? Napakabuti ng Diyos because there are times na minsan nahirapan tayo, nag-aalangan tayo. We don't want to pray. There are times na nanghihina na tayo and we don't want to come to the throne of God because anyway, wala naman nakikita tayong nangyayari na maganda. Okay? Pero naniniwala po ako na as we come, praise God, to the throne of our gracious God. Hallelujah. Even though minsan may mga delays na nangyayari, but I believe that if we are consistent and persistent in asking God for help, praise God, we will experience God's help upon each and everyone's lives. Amen. At hindi po nawawalan ng kabuluhan ang atin pong mga paglapit sa Panginoon. Kaya I want you to just consistently and persistently come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. So ang verse po natin today will be found in Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16. Ang sabi dito, So let us come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. There, we will receive His mercy and we will find grace to help us when we need it most. Amen. So, in this verse, we can see that the verse encourages us as believers, regardless of who we are, regardless of our profession, regardless of wherever we are. Praise God. God is inviting us and encouraging us to come boldly to the throne of our gracious God without hesitation. Amen? So in a difficult situation, in difficult circumstances of life, amen, negative circumstances, crisis, trials, many people are looking for someone to whom they could ask for help. And this time, brothers and sisters, God is giving us the hint, no? Kung kanino tayo tatawag. Praise God, napakabuti ng Diyos sapagkat sa kanyang mga salita, makikita natin that God is giving us the assurance that the Lord will help us in times of our need if we will come to Him boldly, without hesitation, and with positive attitude. Yun po yung kailangan ng Diyos. Amen? Kailangan we are confident, we are bold in coming to the throne of grace of God. Amen? The gracious God is just waiting for us. Praise the Lord. Wala pong pag-aalinlangan yun. That He is always waiting for us, praise God, with His hands open wide. Kaya, mga kapatid, the Word of God is very clear that we should come boldly to the throne of our gracious God because there we can find help, there we can find mercy, and we can find grace. Amen? So, napakabuti ng Diyos. Katulad ng this word is was confirmed also by John. In 1 John chapter 5 verse 14, ang sabi dito, "And we are confident that he hears us whenever we ask for anything that pleases him." So we are confident, sabi ni Peter, ano, na God will hear us if we ask anything that pleases the Lord. If we ask anything that is according to His will, God will hear us. And we are confident, sabi ni John, na talagang sasagot ng Panginoon. Kaya ang Diyos, ano, ay patuloy nating hanapin sa atin pong mga panalangin. Praise God. The Word of God did not say that we should come to Him defeated, okay? Or with feeling of rejection. Ayaw ng Diyos na lalapit tayo sa Kanya na para bang lulugo-lugo tayo, talunan, hallelujah, or rejected. Praise God, let us always come to the presence of God, hallelujah, boldly. Amen, na may katagumpayan. Kailangan you are confident that you will be heard, that you will be answered, your prayers will be answered by the Lord. Amen. And today, it is very important that we should know and understand how we can come boldly to the throne of God. Kailangan alam natin ang mga principles. Alam natin at naunawaan natin kung paano tayo lubusan o tuluyang lalapit sa trono ng biyaya ng ating Panginoon. Amen. So yan ang question natin ngayong araw na to. Praise God, that how can we come boldly to the throne of our gracious God? Number one, praise the Lord, we should know the truth. Amen. Praise God. Isang bagay po na kailangan nating maintindihan sa buhay na ito. If we do not know the truth, then there will be hesitation. Okay? Kung hindi mo alam ang katotohanan, praise God, ang mangyayari sa iyo, mag-aalanganin kang lumapit sa Diyos. Amen? Kahit naman sa mga taong kakilala natin. Kung hindi natin kilala ang katotohanan o kung hindi natin kilala yung tao na yon na lalapitan natin, talagang hindi tayo confident ang lumapit. Praise God. Pero sabi ng Panginoon, ano? Sabi ng John chapter 8 verse 32, praise the Lord, "You shall know the truth and the truth shall make you free." So if you know the truth, that truth will set you free, brothers and sisters. So knowing the truth makes you free. Magiging malaya tayo. Malaya tayong nakalalapit without any hesitation, without any double-mindedness. Amen? If you know the truth, it will boost your confidence to come closer to Him and ask for help. Praise God, nagiging confident ka at ito yung nagbo-boost sa'yo na lumapit talaga ng walang pag-aalinlangan, ano? But if you do not know the truth, then you will miss the opportunity to receive the blessings of God that He has for you. Actually, every day, God is preparing new blessings, ano? They are new every morning, sabi ng isang awitin, "Great is thy faithfulness." The faithfulness of God, the love of God, the blessings of God are new every morning. Hindi po siya nakokontento na ang ibibigay sa iyo ay leftover. Praise God. Ang blessing ng Panginoon sa bawat isa sa atin ay laging bago. But you should know the truth. Amen? You should know the truth. And that is the truth. Praise God. Na ang Diyos natin, He knows everything. Praise God. He knows the way on how he should do it for you. Amen? Alam niya kung paano kanya sasagutin. Amen? Ang tanong dito, who is the truth? Sabi ng John 8:32, "You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." Now, ang question, who is the truth? Praise God. John 14 verse 6 says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Jesus said, ano? "I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one can come to the Father except by Him." Amen? So, if you know the truth shall set you free. Praise God. You can come to the gracious God if you know the truth. Praise God. And who is that truth? That truth is none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen? If you know Jesus Christ, you can come to the throne of our gracious God boldly. Kaya sabi ni Jesus, "If you ask anything to the Father in my name, I will do it." Amen? Kung ano yung hihingin mo sa Ama sa aking pangalan, sabi ni Jesus, gagawin ko yon. Praise God. So, yung katotohanan na yun, mga kapatid, is none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. He Himself is the truth, the way, the truth, and the life. Amen? No one can come to the Father. Praise God. No one can come to the throne of our gracious God without Him. But if you know the truth, if you know Jesus Christ, hallelujah, you can come boldly. And He will answer your prayers. You will find mercy and grace. Hallelujah. Amen. Letter B, praise God, you should know and understand your position in Christ. Okay? You can come boldly to the throne of the gracious God if you know and understand your position in Christ. So knowing your position in Christ will give us the boldness and confidence to access to the throne of our gracious God. Because ignorance of your position in Christ denies you of your legal rights and privileges as a believer of Christ. Kung hindi mo alam ang posisyon mo sa ating Panginoon, glory to God, yung mga pagpapala na dapat ay para sa iyo, mamimiss mo. It denies you your legal rights and privileges. Amen? That's why it's very important for us to know our position in Christ. Amen? So, I'm so excited to share with you your position in Christ. Amen? Hallelujah. Number one, you became a child of God because of Christ. Amen. When you receive Jesus Christ, when you believe in Him, when you put your trust in Him, praise God, you became a child of God. Amen. In other words, we became sons and daughters of God. John chapter 1 verse 12 says, but all who believed Him and accepted Him, He gave the right to become children of God. Amen. So, if you don't believe and accepted Jesus in your heart, you will not be called a child of God. Amen? Because it's very clear from the verse. So in other words, praise God, only those who believe Him and accepted Him, praise God, as their Lord and Savior, will be given the right to become children of God. Amen? So hindi lahat ay anak ng Diyos, mga kapatid. Tayo lang pong mga kumilala sa Panginoon. Tayo lang pong mga naglagak ng pananampalataya sa Panginoon ang mga tinatawag na anak ng Diyos. Amen? So take note, brothers and sisters, you and I became a child of God when we receive Him and believe Him, praise God, and accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Type, I am blessed, praise God, because I am a child of God. Diyan po sa inyong mga chat box, I am blessed. Pakitype po. Amen? So, another verse in Romans chapter 8, verse 15 to 17, sabi dito, for you did not receive the spirit that makes you a slave again to fear, but you received the spirit of sonship. And by Him, we cry, Abba, Father. Okay, pag sinabi pong Abba, Father, meron tong tinatawag na lalim, ano? Merong intimate relationship. Amen? May intimacy. Praise God. So the Spirit Himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Verse 17. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ, if indeed we share in His sufferings, in order that we may also share in His glory. Take note yung verse 17. Makikita natin dyan, we are heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. So tagapagmana tayo, nakasama ng ating Panginoong Jesus. Actually, si Jesus ang nag-iisang bugtong na anak ng Diyos. Amen. Siya lamang ang bugtong na anak ng Diyos. Pero we became adopted, praise God, as sons and daughters of God because of our faith in Him. Amen. Because of our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Kaya, mga kapatid, praise God, you being the child of God, being the sons and daughters of God, sabi rito, you are heirs of God and co-heirs with Christ. Ano ba yung mamanahin natin sa Panginoon? Hallelujah! Sabi ng Psalms 24 verse 1, the earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all its people belong to Him. So, the earth is the Lord's. Lahat ng nakikita natin at mga bagay na hindi nakikita, praise God, the universe belongs to God. Pag-aari ng Diyos because He created them. Pag-aari ng Diyos ang lahat ng bagay, pati ikaw at ako. Lahat ng tao. Pag-aari ng Diyos. Mamanahin natin itong mundong ito sa ating Panginoon. Kaya in the last days, praise God, pag bumaba na yung new heaven and new earth, praise God, kayo at ako ay magiging tagapagmana ng lahat ng napag-aari ng ating Diyos Amang nasa langit. Amen? Our Father in heaven is the owner of everything. Amen? The heavens and the earth, everything that you can see and everything that you cannot see. He loves us so much. Amen? As a father, sabi nga, siyempre tayong mga anak niya, minamahal tayo ng Panginoon. He loves us more than we could ever think. Amen. Na mahal po tayo ng Panginoon that He gave His only begotten Son. Sabi nga roon sa John chapter 3 verse 16. Because God loves us so much, so He gave His Son to die for you, praise God, and so that we may receive His salvation. So, remember, ano, bilang ama natin, at bilang mga anak ng Diyos, ang sabi ng Hebrews chapter 13 verse 5, He promised that He will never leave us nor forsake us. Amen? So, ganun tayo kamahal ng Diyos. Kaya kahit na nasa crisis tayo ngayon, kahit na marami tayong pinagdadaanan, glory to God, God has promised that He will be with us. Amen? He will be our Jehovah Shammah. He will be our Emmanuel. Amen? The God who is with us. Amen? If you believe that God is with us, hallelujah, type God is good. Hallelujah. He is good all the time. Amen? He is with us. Glory to God. Kasama natin ang Diyos. Kaya kung merong dalawa, sabi ng Bible, if there are two or three gathers together in My name, I, sabi ni Jesus, in the midst of them. So si Jesus, nasa ating pong kalagitnaan, and He knows very well what you're going through. Ano man yung pinagdadaanan mo ngayon, kapatid, alam ng Diyos kung ano, kung gaano kabigat, kung gaano kahirap ang pinagdaraanan mo. Kaya wag po kayong mag-alala. Glory to God. Kung nakikita ng Diyos ang ating pong pangangailangan, tutulungan niya tayo. Alam niyo, sabi dito sa Isaiah 49 verse 15 to 16, can a mother forget her nursing child? Can she feel no love for the child she was born? Ano? But even if that were possible, I would not forget you. See, I have written your name on the palms of my hands. Ang sabi ng Bible, ano? Magagawa bang kalimutan ng isang ama o ng isang ina ang kanyang anak na nanggaling sa kanya? Siyempre, ang mga ina, ano, hindi nila makakalimutan yung kanilang mga anak na nanggaling sa kanila. Dinala nila ng 9 months sa kanila pong sinapupunan. How can they forget their children? But ang sabi ng Panginoon, but even if that were possible, kahit na posible man yon, kung mangyari man yon, sabi ng Bible, kung mangyari man na makalimutan ng ina ang kanyang anak na nanggaling sa kanya, sabi ng Panginoon, I will not forget you. Amen? See, I have written your name in the palms of my hand. So that's how deep, how wide, and how strong the love of God for His children. Amen? So that is your first position in Christ. Amen? So you can, if you know that you're a child of God, then you can come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. Amen? Kasi alam mo na ikaw ay anak ng Diyos. Amen? You see, yung mga anak po natin, mga kapatid, hallelujah, kapag ka, yung mga anak ko, ito na lang, mga anak ko, kahit na gabing-gabi na, no, pag gusto nilang pumasok doon sa kwarto namin ni Mrs., hindi na yung kumakatok, basta papasok lang sila. They have the right, ano, they have a legal access. Praise God. Dahil anak namin sila eh. Pero kung hindi namin mga anak yan, mag-aatubili yan na kumatok o mag-aatubili na lumapit sa amin, lalo na kung gabi na. Pero yung mga anak namin, kahit madaling araw, they have an access, legal access, no, sa admin pong kwartong mag-asawa. Dahil alam nila na hindi namin sila itataboy. Praise God. At alam nila na kapag pumasok sila, they are always welcome. And the same thing that God is, that God wants you to know today. Praise God. Because you are a son and a child of God, son and daughter of God, hallelujah, you have an access to the throne of our gracious God. Amen? Hallelujah. If you believe it, then type amen. Praise be to God. So, pangalawa po, praise God, you become a friend of God. Amen? You become a friend of God. Sabi ng John chapter 15, verse 13 to 15, sabi dito, greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends. Praise God. Verse 14, you are my friends if you do whatever I command. No longer I do call you servants, for a servant does not know what his master is doing. But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. So makikita natin dito na itinuturing tayong mga kaibigan ng Diyos. Amen? Kaibigan ng ating Panginoong Jesus. So, sabi ng Proverbs chapter 18, verse 24, there is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. Amen. Hindi lang tayo basta kapatid ng Panginoon, kundi itinuturing tayo mga kaibigan. Naniniwala ako na may mga magkakaibigan dito na mas close pa sila sa kanilang mga kapatid sa laman. Amen. Mas nakapagbibigay ka ng payo or nakapagbibigay ka ng advice doon sa kaibigan mo kaysa doon sa mga kapatid mo, or vice versa. Mas nakakahugot ka ng lakas doon sa mga kaibigan mo. Amen. So ganun din ang ating Panginoon sa atin. Praise God. Hindi na tayo tinuturing na slaves. Praise God. Sabi ng Bible, God is calling you as friends. Amen. A friend, hallelujah, that is closer than a brother. Amen. Hallelujah. So He will always stand by you. Lagi siyang nandiyan, nakalalay sa iyo. So kung kaibigan tayo ng Panginoon, hallelujah, wala pong iwanan. Siguradong hindi niya tayo iiwanan at pababayaan. Amen. So that's your position in Christ. Pangatlo, praise God, you become an ambassador for Christ. Amen. So you become an ambassador for Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 20. Now then we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. So we are ambassadors for Christ. Ano po ba yung trabaho ng ambassador? Ang ambassador po ay he represents the country where he came from. Amen. So if we are ambassadors of Christ, then we are representative of the kingdom of God. Amen. Nire-represent natin ang kingdom ng Panginoon. Kaya praise God, hindi po tayo tagalupa. Tayo po'y tagalangit. Amen. Sabi ng may mga katangian po kasi ang mga ambassador, ano? May mga katangian ang ambassador na gusto ko pong maintindihan ninyo mabuti. Unang-una, as an ambassador of Christ, our citizenship is in heaven. Amen? So, citizenship ay hindi po dito sa lupa. Amen? We are just foreigners, strangers, here on earth. Philippians chapter 3 verse 20, sabi rito, but we are citizens of heaven, where the Lord Jesus Christ lives, and we are eagerly waiting for Him to return as a Savior. So, our citizenship is not here on earth. Our citizenship is in heaven. We may be citizens of the Philippines, or we may be the citizen of UAE or other countries, but the original, praise God, citizenship of each and every believers of Christ, hallelujah, is in heaven. Amen? So, we are citizens of heaven. Kaya, mga kapatid, anuman yung mangyari sa buhay natin, praise God, bawian man tayo ng buhay, kunin man ng Panginoon ang buhay natin, uuwi. Meron tayong uuwi ang langit, which is our eternal home. Amen? Praise be to God. And sabi ng Panginoon, huwag kang mag-alala, no? Do not be discouraged. Do not worry. Praise God, because in my Father's house, there are many mansions. Praise God, iginagawa ka ng Panginoon, ipinagpapagawa tayo ng Lord ng mansion doon sa kalangitan. John chapter 14, basahin po ninyo at makikita ninyo na marami pong mansion doon sa heaven at ang isa doon ay para sa iyo. Amen? Meron tayong kanya-kanyang mansion. So kung meron kang mansion sa heaven, glory to God, sabihin mo sa iyong sarili, thank you Lord. Amen? Sulat mo dyan sa iyong chat box, thank you Lord for the mansion. Amen? Hallelujah! And siyempre, sabi pa rito, no? As an ambassador of Christ, our needs are not met by the economy of the country they are in, but by the country they are from. Okay? As an ambassador of Christ, praise God, ang pangangailangan natin ay natutugunan hindi sa economy ng bansa kung saan tayo nandoon, kundi doon sa pinanggalingan niyang bansa. Amen? Kaya nga sabi ng Philippians chapter 4 verse 19, kung babasahin natin yon, and my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. So in other words, praise God, ang atin pong pangangailangan ay isusupply ng Panginoon not according to the economy of this world, not according to the economy of this country, but according to the economy of heaven. Sabi, yung sa pagpapalang hindi nauubos sa sangkalangitan, sa pamamagitan ni Jesucristo. Amen? Kaya ang atin pong needs, praise God, will be well provided. Kaya tingnan natin yung ating mga katawan kahit na naka-lockdown tayo, kahit may pandemic, praise God, lumalaki yung ating mga katawan pag tingnan natin sa salamin. Praise God. Look at the mirror and you will see that really God is good. Amen. Amen. He has provided our needs, not according to the economy of this country, but according to the riches and glory of in heaven by Christ Jesus. And as an ambassador of Christ, remember that we are chosen to represent the heaven, okay? Kung saan tayo nanggaling. Kasi ambassadors tayo eh. Amen? Kaya representative tayo ng kingdom of God. We are ambassadors for Christ. Matthew chapter 22 verse 14, ang sabi dito, "For many are called, but few are chosen." So as an ambassador, praise God, an ambassador is chosen to represent his country or kingdom. Praise the Lord. So you are chosen by the Lord. Amen. Sabihin mo sa iyong sarili, I am chosen. I am chosen. Amen. John chapter 15 verse 16, anong sabi ron? "You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit and that your fruit should remain." So nandun na naman yung word na chosen. God has chosen you. Amen. Kaya hindi po kayo basta kinuha lang ng Panginoon. Okay? Hindi yung basta ikaw lang ay tinawag ng Panginoon. Okay? Kundi you are chosen. Many are called but few are chosen. And you are one of the chosen. Amen? So, yan po yung atin pong dapat tandaan. Being an ambassador for Christ. And then, ano pa? What else is our position in Christ? Number four, praise God, you are more than conquerors. Wow! We are more than conquerors in Christ. Amen? So, naging isang malaking pagpapala para sa atin yung ating pong pagsusuko ng buhay sa Panginoon because God made us conquerors. Amen? Romans chapter 8 verse 37, ang sabi rito, "Yet in all things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us." You see? Tayo po'y naging more than conquerors. So Jesus Christ won the battle over sin and death. He won the battle over the power of darkness. So siya'y nagtagumpay. Praise God, nung siya'y namatay doon sa krus, praise the Lord, and then inilibing at nabuhay na maguli, yun po yung katotohanan na nung nabuhay na maguli si Jesus, yun po'y picture na siya'y nagtagumpay. And then, nung nagtagumpay siya, praise the Lord, sabi nung 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 57, "But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." Amen? So binigyan tayo ng Panginoon ng katagumpayan. Nung siya'y nagtagumpay, yung tagumpay na dala-dala niya, praise God, was given to you and me. Amen? Binigay niya ito para sa iyo at para sa akin. Luke 10 verse 19, sabi dito, "I have given you authority." Ito yung kapangyarihang binibigay sa atin ng Panginoon. "I have given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome some of the powers of the enemy." Amen? Hindi po some. Kundi ang sabi ng Bible, overcome all the power of the enemy and nothing will harm you. Praise God. So nothing will harm you. Dahil ibinigay sa iyo ng Panginoon ang lahat ng authority. Ano? "I have given you authority." Praise God, to trample on snakes and scorpions. Ano ba itong snakes and scorpions na to? Ito yung mga gawa ng kalaban na nakapananakit sa atin at sumisira ng ating mga buhay. You can trample on snakes and scorpions. Tatapakan mo siya, dudurugin mo ang kanyang ulo. Amen? Kaya wala pong Kristiyano na natalunan. Amen? You are victors, not victims. Amen? Sabihin mo sa iyong sarili, i-type mo dyan sa iyong chat box, "I am victor, not a victim." Amen? We are victors in Christ. Romans chapter 8 verse 31 says, "If God is for us, who can be against us?" We are more than conquerors. Amen? If God is for us, then who can be against us? Sino ba yung lalaban sa atin kung nasa sa atin ang Panginoon? 1 John chapter 4 verse 4, sabi doon, "Greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world." Praise God. Mas makapangyarihan ang nasa sa atin. Sino ba yung nasa sa atin? Siyempre, ang kapangyarihan ng ating Panginoong Jesus. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead is within us and working in us. And that's the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen? Kaya we are more than conquerors. Kaya wala pong Kristiyanong lulugo-lugo. Amen? Walang Kristiyanong talunan. Lahat ng mga Kristiyano, we should stand firm on our faith. And as we stand firm on our faith, praise God, we will always be victorious in every battles, in every circumstances of life. Whether it is hard, praise God, we will always be victorious because God has given us the victory. Amen. So last but not the least, our position in Christ, praise the Lord, you are seated in heavenly places. Hallelujah. You are seated. Nakaupo kang kasama ng ating Panginoong Jesus doon sa Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6. For he raised us from the dead along with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms because we are united with Christ Jesus. So we are seated in heavenly places, brothers and sisters. You are like a prince and princess in the eyes of God. Amen. So, ibig sabihin ito mga kapatid, you are seated in heavenly places which is closer, very close to the throne of God. Amen. Malapit na malapit sa puso ng Panginoon. Praise God. So, if you are seated in heavenly places, okay? So, our position is we are seated with Christ in heavenly places. In other words, nandun tayo sa taas. But somehow, may mga kapatid tayo na it seems that they are always in the bottom, na laging nasa ilalim. Na kapag may problema, lagi silang nakatingin doon. Okay? Pataas. No, it's not the way it is. Amen? If we are seated in heavenly place, in other words, we are looking at our problems as if we are on the top. Amen? Not from the bottom, but from the top. Amen? So, magkaiba yung perspective na yun. Kapag tinignan mo yung problema from the bottom, matatabunan ka ng problema. Amen? Magiging mahirap para sa'yo ang pagtagumpayan ang mga problemang yan. But if you are going to look at it in a different perspective, praise God, because you are in the heavenly places, seated with Christ, hallelujah, when you look at your problem from the top to the bottom, praise God, you will see how God looks at your problems. Kung paano tinitingnan ng Diyos yung problema mo, ganun mo rin titingnan yung problema mo because you are looking at it on the perspective of God. Amen. So, meron bang Kristiyanong talunan? Praise God. Meron bang Kristiyano na biktima? No. Christians, the believers of God, the sons and daughters of God, will always be victorious. Amen. Say it to yourself, I am victorious. I am beloved of God. Amen. I am seated in heavenly places. I am more than conqueror. I am son of God. I am a daughter of God. I am a child of God. Amen. Kaya mga kapatid, huwag nating kakaligtaan yung ating pong posisyon sa ating Panginoon. Dahil once na nakalimutan natin yung posisyon natin kay Kristo, doon po magsisimula ang doubt. Amen. If we forget all of the positions that we are in Christ, then mawawalan tayo ng confidence. Hallelujah sa paglapit doon sa trono ng Panginoon. But if you know your position in Christ, hallelujah, you will always be confident coming to the throne of grace of God. Amen? Walang pag-aalinlangan yon. Hindi ka mag-aalinlangan kasi alam mo that God will hear your prayers and you will find mercy and grace in times of need. Balikan po natin yung sinabi ng Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16. Sabi rito, so let us come boldly to the throne of our gracious God. There we will receive His mercy and we will find grace to help us when we need it most. Amen. As believers of Christ, hallelujah, we should come to God with the right perspective in mind. Amen. We should come to God boldly. Hallelujah. So the Word of God says, come to Him without hesitation, without double-mindedness, without reservation. Come to the throne of God. Hallelujah. The throne of our gracious God with confidence because He will hear you. Anything that you ask for in the name of Jesus because you are son and daughter of God and co-heirs with Christ, remember, God will hear your prayers. Not because you are worthy, amen, not because you are good, hallelujah, but because God is good. Not because you are worthy, but because God is worthy. Now, if you are tired and weary of your circumstances, kung napapagod ka na, nahihirapan ng lubos, may pangako ang Panginoon at mayroong invitation ng Diyos. Sa Matthew chapter 11 verse 28 and 29 says, come to me all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. Amen. Remember, do not let the devil steal from you. Huwag mong hayaan ng kalaban ay nakawin at sirain ang buhay mo dahil sa ignorance. Remember, there's so many people today living in this world who are ignorant of their rights and privileges from the Lord. There are so many Christians, there are so many sons and daughters of God who are ignorant of their rights and privileges. They cannot come boldly to the throne of grace of God because they are ignorant of the truth. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Amen. You have to understand that. The truth will give you an access to the throne of God's grace. Amen. So God's invitation is for everyone. Amen. No exempted, no exemption. All of us can come boldly to the throne of God. Amen. But we should come with humility. Let us humble down before the Lord. God can bless you. God can heal you. God can promote you. God can make you whole. God can heal you. Amen. Wala pong hindi kayang gawin ng Diyos. Ang gagawin lang natin, mga kapatid, sabi nito, come to me. There must be a step of faith coming from us. Amen? Kailangan nating ipakita yung atin pong pagnanasa at pagnanais na lumapit sa Panginoon. Dahil kung hindi natin ito gagawin, praise the Lord, mamimiss natin ang blessing. Beloved brothers and sisters, this is the right time for you to come to Jesus. If you are tired, if you are weary of your situation, God is inviting you. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. Not only rest physically ang ino-offer ng Diyos, amen, kundi even rest for your soul. The soul is our, yung atin pong psychological aspect, yung mind natin, amen. Maraming tao na kapag papahinga physically, pero yung kanilang soul, yung kanilang mind ay hindi. Kaya magulo pa rin. Hindi pa rin nila lubos nararanasan ang tunay na kapahingahan. God is offering you rest for your body and rest for your soul. Kung mararanasan mo to, kung ipagkakaloob mo sa Panginoon ang buhay mo. If you will receive the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Amen. That's the only way that we can receive His mercy and grace. We have to have right relationship with Jesus. We are all sinners. Amen? Lahat po tayo ay makasalanan, pero sabi ng Panginoon, if you confess your sin, He is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. Amen? Napakasimple po ng requirements ng Diyos. Amen? Wala pong hinihinging napakalaki at napakakomplikadong requirement ng Diyos. Kundi, if you confess that you are sinners, if you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and believe in your heart that God has raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. The Word of God is very clear that Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except by me, the Lord Jesus Christ said. Hallelujah. And God gave His only begotten Son, which is Jesus Christ, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life. Brothers and sisters, this is not the right time. The Word of God says, if you hear the Word of God today, do not harden your hearts. Open your heart to Him and receive Him as your Lord and Savior, because tomorrow might be too late. We do not know what tomorrow may bring. But there is one thing that I know. If we are in Christ, hallelujah, we will always be victorious. Amen. There is an assurance of salvation that He's offering to us. Salvation doesn't come from what we did. It comes from what Jesus Christ did for us. It is a free gift. Praise God. Salvation is a gift of God through faith in Christ Jesus. So if you want to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you may just close your eyes, bow your heads. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this opportunity that we are here together, Lord God. We are hearing the word, hallelujah, that inspires our soul and spirit, Father. Lord, sa mga pagkakataong ito, na minsan nagkakaroon kami ng ng takot na lumapit sa iyo. Nag-aalinlangan kami, Lord God, because we are ignorant of the truth. But right now that we have known the truth, Father God, Lord, may you give us the strength, Lord God, and the courage to come to your throne boldly. And right now, Lord, hallelujah, we just want you to take full control of our lives. Lord, sa mga kapatid naming narito, Panginoon, that they wanted, Lord, to receive you as their Lord and Savior. Father God, may you open the heavens for them. Beloved brothers and sisters, if you want to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, just lift up your right hand as a sign that you are surrendering your life to Him. Hallelujah! Huwag mo pong intindihin kung sino yung katabi mo ngayon. Huwag mong intindihin kung sino yung mga taong nasa paligid mo. Just close your eyes. Hallelujah! Imagine that you are standing before the throne of God right now and God is looking at you. Hallelujah! At kung nais mong tanggapin si Jesus habang nakataas ang iyong kamay, sabihin mo ang panalangin ito, Lord Jesus, I thank you for your words. Right now, Lord, I admit that I am a sinner. I have sinned against you, Lord Jesus. I'm asking for your forgiveness. Cleanse me, O Lord God, from all my unrighteousness, from all my sin. Take away my sins, Lord God, and forgive me. Cleanse me by the blood of Jesus. I open up my heart to you, Lord. Please come into my life. Sit upon the throne of my heart. I receive you, Jesus, as my Lord and Savior. I surrender everything into your hands. Please help me to walk according to your will from this day onwards. Thank you, Jesus, for your blessing. Thank you, Lord, for your salvation. Thank you, Lord God, that you are in me, that you are inside of me. Take full control of my whole being. Thank you, Lord. I give you the praise and honor and glory in Jesus' name. You may now put down your hands and I will be the one to pray. Heavenly Father, you know exactly, Lord God, the needs of your people. Nothing is hidden from you. We are just like an open book to you, Father God. Lord, hayaan mo, Panginoon, na sa oras na ito ay mag-umapaw, Panginoon, ang iyong pagpapala sa buhay ng bawat isa. Wherever your people are, I pray, Lord, that you may touch them. Bless them, Lord God, with your strength. Bless them, Lord God, with your healing. Father, in the name of Jesus, if there is anyone who is going through difficult situation, Father God, they are sick, they may need, Lord God, financial needs, Father God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, may you bless them, Lord God, exceedingly. Lord, provide their needs, O God, in the name of Jesus. Make a way for them, for it is your promise, Lord God, that you can make a way where there seems to be no way. You can make even the rivers, Lord God, into the desert. Lord, I praise you because the God whom we serve cannot lie. The God whom we serve, hallelujah, is the God of the universe. Father, I praise you because you are able to do it, Lord God, accordingly, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Exceedingly and abundantly, above and beyond what we could ask or think. Salamat, Panginoon, Lord. Saan man naroong dako, Lord God, ang aking mga kapatid, I pray that the Holy Spirit will continue to move upon them. Embrace them, Father God, in Jesus' name. Touch them, heal them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Patunayan mo sa kanila, Panginoon, that the God whom we serve and the God of the universe, Lord God, hallelujah, is able to heal, is able to supply all their needs. Lord God, you are able, Lord God, to make miracles upon miracles, Lord God, in the life of your people. Kaya, Panginoon, salamat sa oras na ito. We are coming to your throne, Lord God, boldly. Hallelujah. And we are confident, Lord God, that every prayers lifted up to your throne today, Lord God, are heard and answered in Jesus' mighty name. Salamat, Panginoon. I pray na kung saan man naroon yung mga anak, mga magulang, mga kaibigan, Panginoon, ng iyong mga anak na kasama namin ngayon, Father God. Lord, touch them also, Father God. Lord, every family is represented by your people, Lord God, who are watching this video, Panginoon. Lord, in the name of Jesus, may you touch them, Lord God. Hallelujah. And bless them exceedingly and abundantly. Panginoon, maraming salamat sa iyong biyaya at pagpapala. Nagpupuri kami, Panginoon, sapagkat ang Diyos na aming tinatawagan at ang Diyos na aming sinasamba ay buhay, makapangyarihan, at totoong kumikilos sa buhay ng kanyang mga anak. Salamat, Panginoon. Lord, patuloy ka naming pinupuri at pinagbabalikan ng lahat ng pasasalamat at kadakilaan. In the name of Jesus Christ, this we pray. Let everybody says, Amen and Amen and Amen. Praise be to God. So sa oras pong ito, bago tayo maghiwa-hiwalay, praise God, let us lift up our hands towards the heaven. Let us receive the benediction of the Lord. Hallelujah. May the love of the Father, the grace and mercies of Jesus Christ, our Lord, the power and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit will continue to be with us, both now and evermore. In Jesus' name, Amen and Amen and Amen. God bless you all. See you next week.
Every day is a happy day with Jesus. Come on, church, and sing this song. Happy day! Woo!
Oh, what a glorious day.